Hello everybody, Josiah here at Easycators.com, and today I'm just going to do a video to walk through the settings of the opening range breakout strategy that comes with the opening range indicator set on the site at Easycators.com. I had a couple of requests to put together a strategy for this so that people can do back testing and see, you know, what kind of ratios and that kind of thing makes sense as a starting point for, you know, building a trading system. So I've done some work on this in the past, went ahead and fleshed it out and finished it up, and I thought I'd do a quick walkthrough video to show you how the settings work and everything. So let me close this all out here, clean up the chart. So this is what it looks like, and I'm on the SPY, on a 1 minute chart of the SPY, past I think 30 days, yeah. And so you can see on the 1 minute, it's pretty consistent. And you'll see I have the strategy set up to where it will color and highlight if the range is appropriate for taking a trade based on your rules or not. If it's not appropriate or not, if it doesn't meet the rules, then it turns red and tells you not to trade. If it's, you know, acceptable, then it turns green and tells you it's okay to trade. And so let's just go here into the settings and I'll show you how that works. So this, whether or not the day is tradable is determined by the size of the opening range relative to the average daily range. So basically the concept here is that you, that trades are more attractive when the stop can be placed closer to the price action, because that increases the risk to or improves the risk to reward ratio. And so it becomes interesting when you can trade a narrower range than average. So so the opening range colors green whenever it is a range that's lower than whatever multiple of the average daily range you choose. And so down here you can say, you can set up your average daily range calculations here, the length and number of days here, the average type, what time frame you're putting, you're basing this on, which is the daily is the average daily range, but you could do it based on the week or based on the 4 hour chart or something if you wanted. And then you can choose the opening range multiple for, or excuse me, the max range ADR multiple. And so right now I'm saying the opening range has to be less than 75% or 0.75 times the average daily range. And so I could equally set this to 0.5, so it would be half of the average daily range. And so if we look here, that disqualifies an additional day here. Let's see if any other day is disqualified. We have the one back here. So we can make it even more strict and say it has to be less than a quarter of the average daily range. And so you can see that disqualifies a lot more days. And so that's how that works. So let's switch this back out to 0.5. That seemed like a good setting. And let's go in here and we'll look at the rest of the settings here. So starting out, you can set the number of dollars that you're willing to risk on the trade, and it will calculate the number of shares to buy or sell based on that. You set your opening range start and stop times without any separators, and this needs to be an Eastern time. So 9:30 is when the stock market opens and 10 is when the opening range ends in this example. And by the way, there are tooltip hints here to tell you what each setting does if you click on it. Then you can specify, hey, I want to only enter if the time is before a certain time. So you could set this to 1600, which is 4 p.m. Eastern time if you don't care about the time. But if you want it to enter before, say, noon or 1 p.m. or something like that, before the kind of the lower volume in the middle of the day, then you could set that that time frame here, and it would not allow any entries after that time during the day. And then you can set a closing time here, which is in the normal stock market would be 1600 or 4 o'clock Eastern time p.m. And then you can set an exit minutes before the close for a time stop. And so if this is the closing time, then this would tell it to close out any positions 10 minutes before 4 p.m. So at 3:50 p.m., it would close out any open positions that are remaining for the day. Show today only, you can show or hide the ranges on prior days if you want here. You can show or hide the cloud if you don't want to look at the green and red indication there. Show the midpoint, you can show the midpoint line here. And the way that the strategy is set up, you can either set, you know, if you have a breakout like this toward the high, you can set your stop at the midpoint, or you can set your stop at the opposite level of the opening range. So if it's a breakout of the highs, then you can set your stop at the low. If it's a breakout of the low, then it would choose the opposite side at the high and place the stop there. And so you can choose the stop to be at the midpoint or the higher low right here. And so if you use the midpoint, then you might want to show the midpoint, and that is available right there. minimum range size. So like some days, you know, and on some stocks, you might have ranges that are incredibly small and don't make any sense to trade. And so you can specify the minimum that you're willing to take a trade on here for testing purposes. And then your max range ADR multiple, I've already been over that. This is the 0.5 times the average daily range. And so you can choose any multiple there that you want. And these tool tips will tell you how those work as well. Then the opening range multiple for target. So, you know, the typical approach would be to take target at one times the, you know, the range size. So like if you're buying a breakout, you would take the size of the range, project it up above the high, and you would sell at one times that range's size above. And same thing on the lower side, you would buy back at one times the range subtracted from the low of the range. I put 0.95 here as, you know, just kind of front running that a little bit. You could put this at 0.75 if you wanted to really front run it, or 0.5 if you wanted to only look for a half of the range. You could put this at 2 or 3 times the range if you want to go for more intraday swing type trades. So there's lots of different ways you could do that. The break price setting here, this is basically saying, okay, what is considered a breakout? So if you choose high or low down here at the bottom, if you choose high or low, then this candle right here would be considered a breakout because the high passed above the high of the range. If you choose close, then it would not consider this a breakout. It would only consider this candle a breakout because it closed actually above the high of the range. So that's how that works. And so you can see which one of those performs the best in the stocks that you like to trade. And so you can see here also that there was a long stop out at the midpoint. As the price touched the midpoint, then it stopped you out at the midpoint. And that's because the opening range midpoint is set as the stop location. Same thing. Actually, and this is a good example here. This is a long trail out. And so this is an additional setting that is available, and you can turn it off if you don't want to trail the stop to the high of the opening range. So basically the stop is initially put, you know, under these settings at the midpoint, and as the breakout is set, then the stop is placed there. But as price progresses, then the stop is trailed up to the high of the opening range. And so when price dropped back below here before reaching the target, then closed there, then it exited at the close of the bar, the first bar that crossed below that trailing stop. So that's how that works. there's also the time stop where it would exit you 10 minutes before the close of the day. And then the long target, of course, or the short target would be exiting at this line or at this line. And down here, you can see the orders. So we've got the plots here for the, you know, different crossovers and stuff, and the actual lines and levels and so forth. But down here, we've got the orders for the actual strategy. And so we've got long stop. You can change the color of the arrows. You can enable or disable that type of order here. So if you don't want the trail out, you can disable those trails by unchecking this enable box. And so if I hit apply there, close this, we can see how that affects the performance here. You can see it had previously exited on this bar, but since I turned off the trailing stop order type, then it just reverted back to the long stop. And so all those orders can be controlled individually down here. Long exit would be, you know, exiting at your target. Short exit would be exiting at your short target. Then you've got the stop out order types, the trailing stops, the time stops. So you can turn those off here if you don't want to use those. And then you've got your breakout and breakdown orders right here for the entries. So that's how the settings work. I just wanted to walk everyone through that because I know it's a little bit of a mystery sometimes when you get a new script and you know, you weren't the mind behind it. And so you don't know how everybody else thinks. And so it's sometimes hard to see everything the same way. So anyway, I just wanted to walk through that for the benefit of those people that have already purchased the package. This backtesting strategy will be made available for free for anyone that already owns it, owns the opening range breakout set. I'm going to add that to the website, and you can just log into your My Account area orders subsection, and the link should appear there for anyone that already owns it. Anyone else that's interested in purchasing this set, you can go to easycators.com/ORB and pick up a copy of the set of indicators there. So I hope this helps, and I will talk to you next time. Thanks.